think I forget what we were talking about. Talking to someone about it, just being like the most broken E ability, just 55% damage reduction on E-Max, which is what some Brahms do these days, and who he has started working down this dragon.
Yep. Sacking the pressure from bot lane as Core JJ made that attempt for mid lane from the teleport, so he's going to make it here first before Core JJ. This should be Golden Guardian's favorite, but Summit and Pyoshik trying to see if they can look for a steal. APA, Pop Blossom, Flash! Pyoshik stole the Rift Herald as well. Can they look for a re-engage? Golden Guardians are being forced back here. It doesn't seem that they're
already secured the crab, so they have some vision here as Licorice
looks for the all out here, and Summit takes another turret shot, is forced to back away here. It looks like a teleport coming in from Gory, Team Liquid. Not all members quite yet on the dragon as Yawn is starting to pour on in. Gory with the teleport has joined the fight as well. 3,000 HP. Licorice, does he have teleport ready? He does. He can answer as Summit.
To him.
But now Summit it might be forced to flash here, but he dodges the Glacial Prison, and the second dragon is secured for Team Liquid. No one goes down.
Licorice did not blow his TP critically there, so while Team Liquid is able to equalize the dragons, they did not have to spend many resources to contest it. Very risky teleport for Summit, given that his ultimate was on cooldown in that trade, and Gwen without her ultimate this early on in the game is not very useful in 5v5.
Teleport, not a flank angle, but at least he can just prevent Golden Guardians from being able to get in. Rift Herald is secured. Yawn forced to use Cleanse from the Glacial Prison. Now the rest of Golden Guardians, do they want to inch on forward? Core JJ is super low. Flash forward from who? They want to pick this fight. Summit doesn't have Flash anymore. APA Pop Blossom, and now here comes the resets as well. First blood for Summit. Can they look for more? They've already found one, but Stixxay is the one firing around on back. The Pyoshik looking for the Q Flash, trying to interrupt Stixxay, and now he turns his eyes onto Huhi. Stixxay is isolated by Yawn. Huhi is not long for this world, but the True Shot Barrage, enough damage! Gory from over the wall is able to take out Pyoshik, and he jumps right into Core JJ, but he gets clipped in the air by Yawn. What a bloody fight!
The tension finally breaks. It's a 4-for-3 in favor of Golden Guardians.
The Flash Forward from Yawn steps up and gets a kill on this.
Doesn't think that he has Flash still, probably, and ends up getting blown up.
Oh, another fight. River's caught out in the river. Oh my goodness, Team Liquid being able to get a pick off screen. No jungle for the side of Golden Guardians. That's the third dragon for the taking. It'll be the second one belonging to Team Liquid.
Yeah, I went back to rewatch how that happened. Just contesting some vision control, and Pyoshik was camping the brush, lands the W on top of him, and they just blow him up. And like you said, another kill in Team Liquid's favor, second dragon going their way, and getting some map pressure back on their side. Golden Guardians, as soon as he drops though, go to the weak side of the map for Team Liquid, start getting some more gold into Licorice's pockets, excuse me. Be absolutely critical to make sure that they have some pressure.
Yeah.
It was a nice little attempt there as they got their second Rift Herald charge in, but Golden Guardian stood strong, got the turret back, and get some gold into APA's pockets.
Side tier one turret falls. Gory jumps right onto APA, and they look for the Pop Blossom. I don't know if Gory thought that they could just get the kill. I don't know if he thought River and Huey were going to be able to collapse faster.
Core JJ and APA are here as reinforcements as they're starting to surround Licorice. River's here to look for a counter re-engage.
Really nice chunk there, APA and Summit combining together, hitting Licorice under the turret, getting him low. River's running defense as the rest of Golden Guardians collapse, but I don't think they'll be able to save this turret.
That tier one turret is gone, and Team Liquid will be able to outmatch in terms of turrets. Liquid, 3,000 HP. River can't get into a 2,000 two-shot barrage. It is secured by Pyoshik. And now, Core JJ giving his life to make sure the rest of Golden Guardians cannot catch out the members of Team Liquid, but Gory's on the chase. He's already teleported in. Get out.
What a gutsy shot call by Team Liquid there. Knowing that they have the damage. Whoa, aggressive TP in the middle of everyone.
Down, there's nose protection. Summit is forced to flash, and then a teleport is coming in from APA. He has Pop Blossom right on spawn. He looks for the knockup. Gory's able to buffer it with the rocket jump, and he's out of there. But the rest of Team Liquid, do they want to look for a chance to repounce? Multiple members are looking for resets here as Summit and APA are forced to bait.
Keep up on the play, though.
Yeah, but you're down a Pop Blossom, you're down multiple ways of engaging. Core JJ doesn't have Magna Storm, and he's nowhere near the play. This Ocean Dragon belongs to Golden Guardian.
They tried to defend the turrets, they lose the dragon as well, evening it out 2-2. Now they're finally reset onto the map though and starting to break more turrets with this Baron buff.
Looks like the Red Bull Baron buff is able to
maybe. Gory in trouble.
River trying to go for a recall, but now cancels it. He knows that Gory's in trouble. Licorice is forced to teleport. Summit is burning down the dragon. The Pop Blossom follows with a flash. They find Gory, and that's the first reset. Looking for Licorice and River on the back end. Summit now coming in with the teleport as well. Huhi plays defense and slows him down with the winner's bite. And Stixxay's now rejoined the fray. River has looped all the way around into the jungle quadrant of Golden Guardians and has a potential window to look for a steal if they burn down the Baron. But Team Liquid Do they even want to start it up, or do they want to continue forcing a fight? Here comes the Magnusar Flash! Sixsay is able to arcane shift away. The Buster Shot as he looks for another one. Pyosha gets a reset off from the bomb, and Core JJ falls, but Sixsay's under fire. Summon is looking for the damage. The Brick reset finds another one. Sixsay's gone!
Golden Guardian, only River and Licorice left alive, but the Baron's going to be gone too quick for River to come in for the steal. Not gonna happen. Second Baron of the game.
Find angles onto 6A and some trouble.
Huge pick on the Core JJ. He doesn't have flash from before. Golden Guardians know this and then make the punish. Gory looking for the reset, but Yon tries to use the Killer Instinct to reposition himself. But multiple flashes from Ruhi and River punish Yon for his mispositioning. And Golden Guardians find it.
I mean, Team Liquid have the Baron buff on their side, but it's Golden Guardians that are now taking this momentum and pushing into the base. How much more can they get? They are starting to fire and lay siege into the Inhibitor Tower. Summon a Pyosik. AP is forced to recall. They just lost the Inhibitor Tower. They're probably losing this Inhibitor as well.
Golden Guardians grab the Inhibitor, probably going to back off. Respawn's coming through. Core JJ up 10 in a minute and a half. Team Liquid are probably going to be stuck just rotating and maybe grabbing this top outer turf, but then otherwise moving back down to the boss side to set up for that one. Nice stun there by Pyosik.
Licorice getting chunked out, but still tanky enough to survive the onslaught. But that tier 2 to bully their way through the mid lane and through super minions before they can get into the pit.
APA is off on the flank from the top side, baiting Golden Guardians to run slightly too far up into the mid lane. Might open them up to an angle. Here he goes.
He is sneaking right behind vision lines. He's in fog. Glacial Prison is thrown. APA looking for the pop. Lots of run on the stick save. Can Yon sync up with him? Yes, he can. The Killer Instinct. It's not enough damage. Pyosik looking for the reset. One more. He finds it on the stick save. Yon and APA may have just synced up the reset for Pyosik to clean up this fight. Yon is still kiting around River and Hui, but the takes are falling in their moment.
Team Liquid, no minion waves to really utilize right away. But
stakes that have been at hold for both of these teams as a teleport coming in from Summit, trying to pincer on the Golden Guardians. The knockup from Baron dissuades Golden Guardians from being able to sync up. Gory jumps in and tries to blow Summit away with the Buster Shot, trying to kite him out, but he's just going to get melted by Summit. And Team Liquid have found one carry. Six saves out of the fight, firing a True Shot Barrage, but the resets come through onto Huhi. And it's now 5-on-3 Golden Guardians. It's a tall task to try and look for this Baron re-engage.
Don't think there's any opportunity. Golden Guardians are not even gonna look at the Baron after Gory gets blown up by Summit. The four item Gwen absolutely mauls AD carries if you get on top of them. And like you said, the crowd coming alive with chance for Team Liquid, seeing victory on the horizon. Newark, New Jersey on their minds, thinking that this team has such a good chance of making finals weekend if they can just close out this push.
10 seconds left on Gory and Huhi. The teleport is coming in. Team Liquid now looking to brute force their way into the Nexus Herd. One rapidly falls. The second one could fall just as fast. All five members of Golden Guardian just about to spawn. They force the engage on the River. He goes Golden with a stopwatch. Magnusstorm keeps a pin. That's one reset, and that's one frontline member down. All the cards are now left onto the members of Golden Guardian.